the great unknown, where feet may fail, and there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith will stand.
Thank you. super. Are you taking a video of my face?
Yep.
I don't want you to take a video of my face.
Then say something.
Say, hey guys, Ruben here.
I don't want you saying things.
Ruben.
I have a heartbeat in my nose.
You got a heartbeat in your nose?
Yeah.
I just think it's the one and only time you're going to feel your heartbeat in your nose.
I hope.
It's really annoying.
Unless you take out some guy's heart.
Not out of my nose. They have those, right?
A baby sucky?
I think they do.
Yeah, you can get the baby suckies.
Baby sucky.
I think the problem is it's just that big freaking tube in your tiny little nose.
No, don't touch.
It goes all the way to your stomach.
It's a long ways
that
in there.
It's like Stranger Things when they're pulling out the guy's mouth.
But you can breathe.
I can, but it's really difficult.
I know.
And it's very annoying, and it's gonna make me not be able to sleep very well.
You will.
the grave came over me, I was overcome by distress and sorrow. Then I called on the name of the Lord. Lord, save me. The Lord is gracious and righteous. Our God is full of compassion. The Lord protects the simple heart. When I was in great need, he saved me. Be at rest once more, my soul, for the Lord has been good to me. For you, O Lord, have delivered my soul from death, my eyes from tears, my feet from sorrow, that I may walk before the Lord in the land of the living.
Instructs us to ask, seek, and knock as a way of releasing our pain, our hopelessness, and opens us up to living the way that he intended. He delights in giving us good things, which I think makes it much easier to follow his instructions. Once we realize that the breath we use in worshiping him is directly from him, shouldn't that change our perspective on worship and how we worship? That breath breathed into us is what distinguishes us from the rest of creation. From the sun, the moon, the stars, land and the oceans, all creatures. May the reality of the breath of God in you move to a deeper and more meaningful act of worship. We surrender this time to you, Lord, and may we praise you like we haven't. Let's sing.
Thank you. when you come back home, we are going to give you some cookies. The chocolate chips ones.
Mm.
I really miss you, and I miss your hugs.
Aww.
Bye.
Bye. We love Bye. You, Becca. Bye. We miss you so.
Bye.
Thank you.
Recording it right now?
Yeah.
Hi, Grandma. I wanted to say, I hope that Grandma's doing well after your surgery. You're a beast. And hi, everybody else. Auntie Leisha, Uncle Johnny, Stace, Beth, Laurel, people. Yeah, I'm good. I'm alive. Thanks for praying for me.
We're here, and we're here,
and I'm here.
Yeah.
Thank you. Oh, And almost 1 year ago, Becca had to have a liver transplant. And her cousin, Stacy, she graciously, lovingly, gave a piece of her liver for Becca so that she could live. And you know, we stand here today, and there's just so much to be thankful for in the midst of so many other things. But I know that I'm thankful today that we get to worship together with someone who's been through so much and still praises God, no matter what the circumstances. So there's so much to be thankful for and to praise God for. So let's just continue to worship. And can we just take a moment where you are and let's just close our eyes and let's just thank God. God, we thank you again for who you are, that you're a loving, merciful, gracious God. Thank you, Lord, for sparing Becca's life. God, we're so thankful that she gets to continue leading us in worship like this. And Lord, we just come before you and we just say thank you. We praise you. In Jesus' name.